Hello Amarillo, it's Mario Batali here. I'm celebrating my new book, America Farm to Table, and we're making simple dishes that will make delicious cooking more accessible at your house. Today's dish is going to be a fried green tomato sandwich, and you start with local green tomatoes. It's the fall, so they're everywhere. They're also inexpensive. One of the tricks of understanding really good shopping is you don't have to buy the most expensive thing, but if you buy the stuff that's in season, it tastes good. It's also less expensive. So I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna slice the end off, and then I'm gonna cut the tomato into about an 1/8 inch thick slices. Any thicker than that, it's still good. It's just a lot more tomato. One of the great things about really good food is they're simple, but they're also as much about balance as they are about the abbondanza. Season the tomatoes with a little bit of salt, a little bit of fresh cracked pepper. I like more pepper than less pepper with a fresh tomato like this. And then take whatever local cheese you have. In this case, I'm using a local goat cheese in New York State. But you could find whatever beautiful Texas cheese you could have. I know there's some really great cheeses down there, and there's a lot of really interesting gastronomic culture going on. So just find stuff that local people are gonna make, because that's the success of the dish. Then I take a sage leaf, I tear it in half, and I press it right on top of that cheese. Another case of don't put more if you think more is gonna be better. Balance is actually the success of the dish, and the tomato is kind of the main event. So you're trying to enhance that kind of beautiful tannic, almost bitterness to it, but you're also gonna sweeten it up. So we're gonna take a little bit of prosciutto. If you didn't have prosciutto, any great meat that is around the house would be great. If you had leftover meatloaf or sliced roast turkey or even barbecue would be really kind of good on the inside of this. Then I take a little bit more salt, season the outside of the top, and then dredge it in seasoned flour in a traditional breading station. We put it in the flour, then we put it in eggs beaten with a little milk and a little bit of salt. If you wanted to personalize this, you could jack up a little bit of flavor by putting some cayenne in the egg here, because that would be an interesting thing. Then I dredge it in a little bit of panko breadcrumbs, which are Japanese-style breadcrumbs, which have a remarkably crunchy texture. And I throw them right here in the pan with a little bit of extra virgin olive oil. Now, all said, already done, you know this is going to be good. You cook them until they're light golden brown. I'd say about 2 minutes on the side, but if your pan's moving quickly, you always want to make sure you're just paying attention and watching it carefully. When they're cooked, you've turned them over. They look just like this. Golden brown on the top, succulent and molten on the inside. Take a little leaf of fresh basil, put it down like that, add a lemon wedge, and there you have it. It's an appetizer, it's a lunch with a little bit of salad, it's something delicious. It recognizes your local farm, and it makes you happy, and me happy too. Thank you.